Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to more Life is Strange. In the previous part, we shot some bottles after taking forever to find them, albeit not as long as I thought it would take, but still took a bit longer than I would like. Anyways, we also then passed out from overusing our, I guess, psychic, question mark, energy, ability, whatever you want to call it, and then Chloe just let us rest on her while we were passed out. So let's go and continue this stuff.
Okay. Looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble?
Oh, boo-hoo. Max is afraid.
I know you can handle this. And I'm here to guide you.
Make That's me cool.
proud, sister.
Oh, who could that be? Mysterious person wandering about?
Stelma and Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe?
That's kind of super bad.
They all say that, you know, even when they're broke and acting tough. What are you hiding there, girlie? Let me see.
Where did you get that bracelet?
Oh, we've seen something like that before.
It's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now, asshole.
Whoa. You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please. Please step back.
You're kidding. Put that down.
Things are starting to get a little serious. Do we shoot or do we not shoot? Decisions. As usual, we're going to do the customary countdown. In 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
That is empty. Oh, man.
Son of a gun.
I'll remember you, kid. I'll remember you almost shot me. And you'll wish I had no memory, because I never forget. You have until Friday to pay me.
Huh.
Never pull crap.
Where are the
like
odds? That's also the day that everything
the
ends.
Next time you do. Try bullets next time, brainiacs.
Sorry.
You are awesome. Thanks for standing up for me.
Yay, we got props.
Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Don't we all want money? That would be a great thing
to
have.
I almost shot this guy. And now he'll be more dangerous to Chloe and me.
Oh, don't be so serial. Everything will be fine, just
fine.
Why
did Frank have Rachel? Chloe's waiting to go for a walk. We both need
to. Gotta love when lines overlap one another.
I still can't believe you pulled a gun on Frank. That was epic.
It felt awful. I'm glad there was no bullets in there.
You can just rewind time in your hand and stick that barrel right up Frank's ass. You have the power!
You're gross. Don't fall.
And here we have one of the more iconic shots of the game.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk. Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Once again, I'm sure we all have those moments that we just want to last until time itself ends.
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
Seriously, Chloe, this is scary. What if Frank tries to track us down?
I'm sorry, but Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, did you see what just happened? I almost shot him. I know I could rewind, but Chloe, This is not playtime. No more guns.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers, he's just a dealer where I get my weed. The one in your...
Are there any people without last names?
Anyway.
I think I guess some people, you know, go through government stuff to do that.
Is this your bad boy phase?
No, it's my trying to scrounge some quick cash so Rachel and I could get the hell out of here phase. Frank had quick cash, that's all.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
This one seems appropriate.
I don't know anymore. My brain is so fried from all this. I need a mental enema.
There's an image for you.
It's weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed. I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
Time to get some good photography shots, and everything is just going to be good old normal, and of course it isn't. Can't get one moment of peace and quiet without something going awry, can we?
Max! Help! I'm stuck!
Hold on, Chloe.
Well, isn't that just the loveliest of things? Oh shit, indubitably. Let us see if I remember how to do this.
Shit, I can't budge it at all.
Let's see, what can I find?
Come on, Max! Hurry!
Alright, let's reverse time a bit. So that way we have more time in order to help our friend out.
Can definitely
there we go.
Use this bad boy.
We can now be Rule 63 Gordon Freeman. Nope, that's not what I meant to do.
Score!
Come on, Max! Hurry!
Let's see, what do we have in here? Nothing, damn it.
Please, get me out of here!
Now I can pull a total MacGyver.
There we go. Where's the train? No, just to be sure.
Please, get me out of here!
Awesome, it's not locked. But which wire to cut?
Red one, right?
Now that's the right cable.
Yeah, first try, wow. Okay.
Yes, I did it.
Usually don't get that done as fast. I'm starting to get somewhat good at this.
You okay?
You saved me again. Crazy. Now we're totally bonded for life.
Damn. That was close.
Yeah, just a bit too close.
Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
Oh, the feels! Ooh! Ooh, the feels.
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Also, I didn't bring this up, but there is so much detail on the interior of Chloe's truck.
Power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
Explain what? Snow equals a ginormous twister that takes out Arcadia Bay? You're high.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
Well, I know, but apparently Max does not.
It means shit happens, right?
No, crazy shit happens.
I'm not sure if you hear that in the background, but the cat is currently acting up quite crazily.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you?
Seems to be a thing with Let's Players.
We have a tornado.
Always has to be a crazy cat in the background.
And freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar.
Like he said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a shitty week and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again.
I can also totally relate to that, you know, having a terrible week yet the best one ever at the same time. Because it's all about your mental state. Alright, and we are now back in Blackwell Academy officially. Back in the halls of it. Oh, and now the cat just jumped up into the back of the chair. He's climbing up.
I have a little time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
So we could talk to Principal Year, but I'm going to do not that. Let's see, what do I want to do? Let's go this way.
Max. Can we talk?
Do we have to talk?
I know things got a little heated yesterday in Chloe's room. Was that really your reefer?
Yes, it was. You know that marijuana is almost legal in Oregon. I can get it at Blackwell. Are you gonna bust me now, Mr. Madsen?
Even I'm not that much of an asshole. And I am sorry about yesterday. I was wrong.
Character development, ladies and gentlemen.
But it has been.
Or at least character complexity?
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
What about Kate?
You stepped between us at a pretty bad time. She's another matter entirely.
Kate hasn't done anything wrong.
Max, this isn't just about Kate Marsh. My concern is for the safety of all Blackwell students, including you.
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security?
Unless
you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max.
All right, good. Good talk, good talk, good talk. Let's go. Let's see, got a little poster there. I'm in the sci-fi lab. Now, I'm no Schrodinger's kitty. Okay, then.
I still have time. I could go see Warren playing mad scientist in the lab. Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer! Perfect timing! I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
Have that either a
Yeah, aren't you supposed to be the science guy? And yet you're asking the photo person to help with your science. I see a little bit of a problem there. Let's go with this.
I'm not sure why you're letting me decide your fate, but... Go... Potassium.
Potassium it shall be. If this works, you get a free hug.
Oh, you are trying way too hard.
Weird science.
Hey, Warren.
Let's try that again with...
Asking me...
Have that...
Lots of potassium.
I actually think you should use a lot of potassium. I mean, a shitload.
See? Look at that smile. You're going to become a scientist yet. Let's do this thing.
That was a much better answer. Ooh! I love how Max had absolutely no reaction to that.
She blinded me with science.
Good stuff, and we could talk to Miss Grant to get an even better reaction, but I think that's good enough for now, and we really just need to keep going.
So you can't help me?
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
Why? You don't understand mine.
Oh no, poor Kate, no!
Excuse me, Max. Can you come over here?
Sure.
You look worried. Is everything okay?
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Jefferson.
I'm only bothered when you avoid turning in photos. But you know this. So what can I do for you, Max?
Just between you and me, I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
That's no secret. Word on the street is that you and Kate had a little confrontation with our security chief yesterday.
I stepped in between David Madsen barking all up in Kate's face about something. She doesn't deserve that.
Of course not. Mr. Madsen isn't the most gentle soul.
To put it absolutely mildly.
He instigated the situation.
My word isn't good enough? The one time I choose not to take a picture.
Always take the shot. My number one rule of photography. And Max, I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Kate is freaked out by all of this. She can't do homework while she's being tormented on a daily basis.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much. She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
Oh, these types of people. Oh, this person clearly bought it on themselves. Blah, blah, blah. Just blah, blah. Hate bullies. Bullies of all kinds! And right now, Mr. Madsen... Mr. Jefferson. Yeah, my brain is fried today. Maybe I'm the one who needs the mental. You see, I cannot words. I cannot use words. Anyways, maybe it is you. Mr. Teacher. You're being the bully right now. Just a little bit. You know. And maybe I'm being crazy, but you just kind of are at the moment, in my opinion.
Yes, I talked to her on the phone today. She needs friends and support now. I just don't want Kate Marsh to become the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
I miss Rachel too. But think about yourself, Max. Principal Wells told me about what you said happened in the bathroom.
That was a private conversation. Not that I wouldn't tell you.
This is a serious accusation, Max.
So you don't believe me? I would never make something like this up.
I hope so, Max. But it's easy to point fingers. If Mr. Madsen claims you might be a pot dealer as he did, should I believe him?
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
Lovely, lovely, lovely! You know what else is lovely? The fact that we have reached the end of this part. I'd like to thank you for joining me for this little adventure. Sure. Okay. And I see Mr. Madsen. Ugh, why keep on them? Mr. Jefferson! Bah! Words! Names! Use them correctly! Deed up! Ugh. Anyways, join me next time where hopefully I will words better. Probably not, but you know, there's hope. Right?